in Bengaluru. A wall in Mantri Mall caves in. 4 injured, visitors and staff evacuated. In Delhi, spine-chilling confession of a serial rapist leaves the nation shell-shocked. A 38-year-old tailor has revealed that he has been sexually assaulting a number of schoolgirls over the years. Yet another shocker from Karnataka. 2 policemen suspended in Tumkur for allegedly raping a mentally challenged woman on the pretext of dropping her home. No arrests have been made so far. Hello and welcome. You are watching The Big Story here on Magic Bricks Now. I am Krishna Kumar. One policeman in Tumkur in Karnataka has been accused of raping a mentally challenged woman. According to the victim's mother's complaint, the culprit, Assistant Sub-Inspector Umesh, spotted the 31-year-old woman who was standing alone and subsequently offered her a ride back home. But as soon as she got into the vehicle, the policeman raped her. After the complaint, the accused cop has been suspended from duties. We have my colleague Shrija getting us all the details of this report. Take a look.
A shocking incident of rape has come to light where an assistant sub-inspector of police, Umesh, raped a mentally challenged woman aged 32 years. The incident is said to have taken place on Saturday night in Tumkur. According to Tumkur Superintendent of Police, Isha Pant, the victim had picked a quarrel with her family members and left home at around 7 p.m. on Saturday, and at around 11 p.m. Umesh spotted the woman. It is alleged that the accused was on his police motorcycle along with his home guard. On the pretext of dropping her home, the assistant sub-inspector of police raped the woman in a moving vehicle before dropping her home at about 3:30 a.m. He has been arrested on charge of raping a mentally challenged woman. The police have taken driver Ishwarappa into custody for interrogation to find out whether he is an acquaintance of Umesh. In Bengaluru, Shrija for Magic Bricks Now.
ರಾತ್ರಿ ಏನೋ ಫೋನ್ ಬಂತು, 2 ಸತಿ ಮಾಡಿದ ನಾನು ಎತ್ತಲಿಲ್ಲ, ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಮಾಡಿದ ಆಮೇಲೆ ಎತ್ತು, ಯಾರು ಇಷ್ಟೊತ್ತಲ್ಲಿ ಫೋನ್ ಬಂತಲ್ಲ ಅಂತ ತೋಡಕ್ಕೆ ಎಲ್ಲಿರೋದಪ್ಪ ಅಂತಂದ್ರು, ಜಯನಗರ ಅಂತ. ಹೌದಾ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಂಗಿನ ಯಾರು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮಿಸ್ ಆಗೋರೆ, ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಅದ್ರಸ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಬಿಡಿಸ್ದಾಗ ಬಾ ಅಂತಂದ್ರು. ಆಯ್ತು, ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಸರ್, ಇರಿ ಸರ್, ನನಗೆ ಹುಷಾರಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ತಿರ್ಗಿನ ಸತಿ ಮಾಡೋದು, ನಮ್ಮ ಅಮ್ಮ ಕೊಟ್ಟಮ್ಮ ಹುಷಾರಿಂದ ಹೆಂಗೆ ಮಾಡೋದಮ್ಮ ಸರ್, ರೆಡಿ ಆಗ್ತಿದ್ದೆ ಇಲ್ಲ, ಚೀಪ್ ಐತೆ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಬರ್ತೀನಿ. ಆಯ್ತು ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್, ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಹೇಳಿ. ಆಯ್ತು, ಬಟವಾಡಿದ್ದು ಬಂದು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದೆ. ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ನಾನು ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸರ್, ಅದೇ ಸಿದ್ದರಾಮೇಶ್ವರ ಬಡಾವಣೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಹತ್ರ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ ನಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ. ಹಂಗೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್, ಹಂಗೆ ಹಂಗೆ ಭದ್ರಮ್ಮ ಸರ್ಕಲ್ನಿಂದ ಬಂದರೆ ಹತ್ರ ಆಗುತ್ತಲ್ವ ಅಂತ. ಹ್ಞೂ ಸರ್, ಹಂಗೆ ಬನ್ನಿ. ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಮಾರ್ತಿನಗರದಾಗ ಬಂದು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರು. ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿದಾಗ ಸರ್, ಇನ್ನೂ ಚೂರು ಮುಂದೆ ಕೆಳಗಡೆಗೆ ಬರ್ರಿ, ಅಲ್ಲೇ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಪ್ಪ ಇರ್ತಾರೆ, ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಈಚೆ ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್, ರೋಡಿಗೆ ಬರ್ರಿ ಅಂತಂದರು. ಆಯ್ತು, ಬರ್ತೀನಿ ಬರ್ರಿ ಅಂದರು. ಬರ್ತಿದಂಗೆ ನಮ್ಮ ನಮ್ಮ ಅಕ್ಕನ ಕೆಳಗೆ ಬಿದ್ದ ಹೊಡಿಸಿ, ನಾವು ಕಿರ್ಚಾಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟವಳೆ, ಅಕ್ಕ ಅಮ್ಮ ನಾನು ಹಾಳು ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ರು, ಹಾಳು ಮಾಡಿಬಿಟ್ರು ಅಂತ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಯಾರು ಪಿ ಸಿ ಇದ್ದವರು, ಅಲ್ಲಿ ಡ್ರೈವರ್ ಇದೆ ಸರ್, ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್, ಬನ್ನಿ ಸರ್ ಅಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಎತ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೊರಟ್ಬಿಟ್ಟ.
ಇಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಇದ್ದೀನಿ?
ಇಬ್ಬರೇ ಅಂತೆ. ನಾನಿರಲಿ,
ಜೀಪ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ದೆ,
ಜೀಪ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಜೀಪ್ ನೋಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ.
ಹಾಂ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ತಾಯಿ ಗುರುತ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ ಅವ್ರನ್ನ? ಯಾರು ಯಾರು
ಐಡೆಂಟಿಫೈ ಮಾಡ್ತಾರೆ? ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮಕ್ಕ ಅವ್ರಿಗೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ವರ್ಷ?
32.
ತಿಳುವಳಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲ, ತಿಳುವಳಿಕೆಯಲ್ಲ, ಅವ್ರಿಗೇನು ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ಲ ಅಷ್ಟೇ.
ಅಲ್ಲ, ಎಲ್ಲಿಂದ ಎಲ್ಲಿ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಡು ಹೋದ್ರೆ?
ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನೆ ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಹೋಗೋದಂಗೆ ಗೊತ್ತಾಗಲ್ವಲ್ಲ ಸರ್, ಅಡ್ಮಿಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ವಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಮನಸ್ಸಲ್ಲಿ 2-3 ಸತಿ ಮೇಲೆ. ತಿರ್ಗಾ ಮೊನ್ನೆಯಿಂದ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಸರ್, ಮೊನ್ನೆ ಎಲ್ಲೋ ಹೋಗಿದ್ಲು, ಯಾರು ಗುರ್ತಿರ ನೋಡ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ಫೋನ್ ಮಾಡಿ ಕರ್ಕೊಂಬಂದ್ಬಿಟ್ಟು ನೆನ್ನೆ ಈ ಥರ ಆಗಿರೋದು.
In fact, the Times Network questioned Karnataka's Chief Minister, Mr. Siddaramaiah, on this particular case. Listen to what he had to say.
It's almost like that.
I have mentioned it, yes, in the police conference.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I told the police officer to take strong action against him, dismiss him from the service, and put him behind the bars.
See, whether it is an ASI or whether it is anybody, such inhuman actions are, you know, we see and we hear and we read. Definitely, I think it's very appalling that such incidents happen. Society, you know, in our society, these kind of people are there and they have to be put down, I think, in the most harshest manner possible under the law. So, I think law should take its course and see that, you know, these people are punished. And ultimately, whether it's an ASI, could be anybody for that matter, that doesn't make any difference on the nature of the crime or the seriousness of the crime. Yeah, so it is disappointing that someone who is supposed to be enforcing the law will go and do this kind of an horrific act. So it just goes to show that across lines, you know, people are, there are good and bad in all sections of society. But the worst part is here, the person who is supposed to be protecting them has gone and done this, especially on a girl who is mentally challenged. So it is, I think, a very sad incident. It's very horrifying. And I think under the law, the extreme punishment, whichever is there, should be dealt to this person.
In fact, for that big story, we're now being joined by Mr. Shankar Bidri, former DG and IGP of Karnataka. Mr. Shankar Bidri, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here on the big story on Magic Prix. Now, this is a horrific incident. It's coming on the back of a few in the city of Bengaluru, in the state of Karnataka. But this one is even more peculiar. It's because the person who is meant to uphold the law is the one committing the crime, isn't it?
Surely it is a crime. Karnataka has got 1,10,000 police force. We are like other professions also. In our profession also, a very, very microscopic minority people are very bad people. This is a very tragic incident. It should not have happened. Now, on account of the act of one person, the entire force of 1,10,000 is made to bow their head in shame. It's a disgraceful event. I'm sure we have got a very good SP there. He will certainly take deterrent action, even in the law of the land also, for custodial molestation and atrocity. The very serious punishment is provided in the Indian Penal Code. I'm sure our SP Tumkur
is the most harshest punishment that can be meted out to this particular policeman, this particular gentleman. What, according to you, needs to be done right now?
I am confident that because whatever may be the crime now, however heinous it may be, however gruesome it may be, however condemnable it may be, all the officers and will have to act according to law only. But I am confident we have got a very, very good SP there in Tumkur district. He will definitely take a very deterrent action and exemplary action against the culprit. And he will weed him out of the force.
Mr. Bidri, I want to ask you, what in a normal course of action is the punishment that's meted out to a policeman who commits a crime like this? And this particular one is even more heinous than others, isn't it?
Yes. Custodial molestation is always heinous. And it has been provided for enhanced punishment in the Indian Penal Code. According to that only, action will be taken.
So, is this policeman looking at a jail term? Can he be put behind bars? Apart from being suspended from the police force, which he already has been, is the punishment according to the law that needs to be given to this policeman?
Suspension is already done, I think.
Yes.
He will be put behind the bars. There will not be any discrimination. There will not be any leniency just because he is a serving police officer. He will be dealt with as an ordinary criminal. He will have to suffer for that.
All right, Mr. Shankar Bidri, former DG and IGP of Karnataka, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here on the big story in Magic Prix. Now, we also have lawyer and activist Ms. Abha Singh joining us on the phone line. Abha Singh, this particular crime against a woman is shocking. And talk to us as a lawyer, how does law provide to prosecute a policeman committing a crime like this?
It's absolutely appalling that a policeman who is supposed to protect is now himself violating a girl, molesting a girl. And if the child is a minor, then of course POXO Act will be applicable. That is Section 6, where it's 10 years to life imprisonment. However, if she is above 18, then 376 of the RPC, where 376C specifically, if it's a policeman, a person in authority, he rapes a woman, then it is 10 years to life imprisonment. Accordingly, I think now that I just heard that he has been arrested and put behind bars, but the big issue is that the case should be foolproof, because it will be his colleagues who will be making a charge sheet, and we must ensure that they don't play up with the charge sheet, leave some loopholes so that he comes out scot-free.
Abbas, I also wanted to ask you, custodial rape and molestation is not new as far as the country of India is concerned. Talk to us about the cases that you have come across, and what are the numbers saying at this point in time, what can be done to first of all start reporting custodial rape and molestation, and of course getting the right punishment to the culprits.
Yes, custodial rape has happened earlier also. The famous Mathura case where this woman was raped by two constables in the police station where she had gone to lodge a complaint is quoted in all the cases. But however, that case was punishment was she was not given in the right earnest because they felt that character was discussed. And in fact, at that time only the order came that a victim's character is not to be discussed in that in case. And there have been many more cases after that. The law has become tough. In fact, the Criminal Law Amendment Act 2013, after Nirbhaya case, made rape, custodial rape, and particularly rape by policemen or people in authority, even a heinous offence. And a new section was added, that was 376C, where provision for life imprisonment was also provided. I think this should be dealt very seriously because the message has to go, if even men in uniform start doing such things, where would the common man go? Where would the innocent girls go? So this needs to be dealt very seriously. Also, one thing which can help is by having CCTV cameras at all these police stations and etc. so that it is also a deterrent.
All right, Abha Singh, please hold on the phone line because let's now listen to what Uma Shri, the woman and child welfare minister of the state of Karnataka, had to say on the matter.
ತಲೆ ತೆಗಿಸ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥ ವಿಚಾರ ಹಾಗೆ ನಾವು ಇದನ್ನು ತೀವ್ರವಾಗಿ ಖಂಡಿಸ್ತೇವೆ. ಈಗ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಅದನ್ನು ಅರೆಸ್ಟ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ದಾರೆ, ಜೊತೆಗೆ ಆಕೆಗೆ ಬೇಕಾದಂತಹ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿಯ ಸಹಕಾರ ಬೇಕೋ ಆ ರೀತಿಯ ಸಹಕಾರವನ್ನು ಈಗಾಗಲೇ ಡಿ ಸಿ ಅವರ ಒಂದು ನೇತೃತ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಮತ್ತು ಎಸ್ ಪಿ ಅವರ ನೇತೃತ್ವದಲ್ಲಿ ಕೊಡಮಾಡಲಾಗ್ತಾ ಇದೆ. ಇದು ಒಂದು ಪೈಶಾಚಿಕ ಕೃತ್ಯ, ಅಮಾನುಷವಾದಂಥದ್ದು, ಇದನ್ನು ನಾನು ಖಂಡಿಸ್ತೇನೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಈ ಒಂದು ವಿಕೃತ ಮನಸ್ಸುಗಳನ್ನು ನಿಯಂತ್ರಣ ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿದ್ರೆ ನಿಯಂತ್ರಣಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಿಕೊಳ್ಬೇಕು ಅಂತಂದರೆ ಬರೀ ಒಂದು ಕಾನೂನು ಇರ್ತಕ್ಕಂಥದ್ದಲ್ಲ, ಒಟ್ಟು ಸಮಾಜ, ಒಟ್ಟು ಪುರುಷ ಸಮೂಹವೂ ಕೂಡ ಇಂಥದ್ರ ಬಗ್ಗೆ ಹೆಚ್ಚು ವಿಚಾರಗಳನ್ನು ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂತಕ್ಕಂಥ ಮನವಿಯನ್ನು ಕೂಡ ನಾನು ಸಮಾಜಕ್ಕೆ ಮಾಡ್ತೇನೆ.
That's from the government, the establishment, Abha Singh. What do you think state governments can do? At the end of the day, you need government support for to prosecute police officers, isn't it?
Exactly. It becomes very difficult because definitely the public prosecutor and also the police investigating, the people investigating and filing the charge sheet are policemen. And that is why I think the case should be transferred to the state CID, as was the case in Mumbai, where a constable had raped a woman while he was on duty in the police chowki. I remember his name was Sam More. So that case was important where he was dismissed from service. So I think the CID, the state CID, should be handed over the investigation so that the independence of the investigation and integrity of the investigation is maintained. And the person must be dismissed from service. And that is secondly, but he must be given life imprisonment so that the message goes that if you are wearing a uniform, you have a special responsibility towards the society and the uniform cannot be abused like the way it has been done in this case.
Absolutely. Please hold on the phone line, Abha, because we're now being joined on the phone line by Mr. Nasir Hussain of the Congress Party. Mr. Hussain, this is absolutely shocking. Something needs to be done from the state government's end to first of all, get justice in this particular case and make sure this doesn't happen again, isn't it?
I completely agree with you and the previous speaker that this kind of an incident is not only shocking to you people, it is shocking to the entire state, people residing in the entire state and the country. Something of this sort is not expected from especially from the people who don the uniforms to protect the people at large. But a person who has the responsibility and the duty to protect people, he goes on to commit such a crime is something which can't be tolerated, which can't be pardoned off. The chief minister has already given a bite, and he has this constable has already been suspended. That immediate inquiry will be done, and strictest available punishment that can be given to this person will definitely be given by the state government.
All right, can you tell us what is going to be the next plan of action as far as this particular case is concerned from the state government's end going forward?
I think the logical and well laid out practices in these kind of cases is that they are suspended immediately and there is an inquiry. the moment the inquiry is closed, the charge sheet is filed and he is not in the suspension will already be done, and I think he'll be thrown out of the service, and then there'll be a case which will the court will try him, and then the court will give him the punishment.
All right, Mr. Nasir Hussain of the Congress, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here. Abba, is there anything that you would like to ask Mr. Nasir Hussain before we let go of him?
One important thing which I feel is that such rogue elements who are there in the services, why is a dossier not kept of them? Why should they be given important positions or kept in law and order? So I think it is necessary that the a dossier of these rogue constables is maintained. It should be, in fact, even at the time of recruitment, their character verifications, it is seen, is not done. They get fake certificates. So the time has come that even while recruiting its constables, efforts should be made that such elements are not recruited.
Mr. Hussain, did you hear out what Abba Singh had to say? That needs to be done going forward, isn't it? So that we don't get to this particular stage.
It's a very good suggestion from Abba Singh. And these kind of suggestions should be taken up by the government. I'm sure the people in the government, those who are listening to this suggestion, will definitely have a serious look at it. I think, I don't know if this person had any antecedents of this kind of behavior. But anyway, I think... especially people, those who are in police, in other services, if they're prone to have this kind of an behavior, I think that should be documented so that you have a sort of a history of these kind of people, those who are in the services.
All right, Mr. Nasir Hussain, we'll go at that. And Abba Singh, thank you so much to both of you for taking time out to be with us here on The Big Story of Magic Pricks. Now, in fact, we have a very special guest joining us live from Bengaluru now, and that is Brinda Adige, social activist from our Bengaluru studios. Brinda Adige, as always, thank you so much for taking out your time to be with us here on The Big Story on Magic Pricks. Now, this is a very specific case. It's a case of custodial rape and molestation. We just heard out what Abba Singh had to say, that these cases need to be brought to the fore, and finally justice needs to be delivered and needs to be documented as well. That is the consensus right now. We had Nasir Hussain of the Congress also speak to us and say that we need to also make sure that the state government puts its might behind cases like this so it doesn't repeat again. Abba Singh in fact had a suggestion saying that there needs to be better screening of people who are recruited in the police force, and that will help avoid such heinous crimes to take place. I want to understand what you are thinking at this point in time.
I agree with all of their suggestions, but I would also like to point out that just screening in the beginning of recruitment is not enough. It is important that they go through similar screening or similar psychological tests and assessments at least periodically while they are in service, because we all know that violence against women, crimes on women, rape on women, all of this is power play. And as the as their ranks increase, probably that feeling of power being quite lot increases, and that is why it is important that they are periodically screened and assessed and told where they could be placed and where they cannot be placed. But more than that, it is the need of the hour just now, both by the police system as well as by the politicians holding the power of the Home Ministry, to reassure and tell the people, tell the citizens that everything is being done to see that such things do not reoccur again. It is also very important to show that even if it is their own person, a person in uniform, there will be nothing spared. There would be no loopholes, there will be nothing. It would be a watertight case, so that a lesson is taught to perpetrators, especially those holding power and authority.
That is crucial, isn't it, Brinda? The fact that we need a watertight case, because it's clearly not the first case. Custodial rape and molestation is a systemic disease as far as India is concerned, irrespective of which state. And to make a watertight case and tell other policemen that if they even dare to do something like this, they will be brought to book. That is the need of the hour right now, isn't it, Brinda?
Absolutely. Absolutely, there is no doubt about it, because we know, we have been watching the other case that police have filed in Delhi. the pedophile, the perpetrator, over 500 children, and he was filed under POXO and he got bail. The whole question is, what was the investigation? What was the charge sheet? What was presented before the judiciary?
All right.
How is it that he got bail? Because he continues to do these things. Same thing applicable over here.
All right, Brinda, please hold your thoughts because we have Isha Pant, the SP of Tumkuru, joining us on the phone line. Isha Pant, thank you so much for taking time out to be with us here on The Big Story on Magic Bricks. Now, this is an absolutely shocking incident, and this comes on the back of several shocking incidents from Bengaluru over the past couple of days. Talk to us, what exactly is being done on this particular case at this point in time?
Yeah, so we have taken serious cognizance of this particular case because it's of a very grievous nature. And the ASI has been arrested, and another accused who was the driver of the private vehicle, he's a private person, he has also been arrested, and they have been produced in front of the judicial magistrate. At the same time, I had suspended this particular ASI last night as soon as I got to know about this incident. And we are going to summarily dismiss this person.
All right, Isha Pant, we're just talking to Brinda Adige, an activist from Bengaluru, from the state of Karnataka, and her, and we had other people on the show as well, and all the common consensus seems to be that in this particular case, there needs to be a watertight case so there are no loopholes, and somebody like him, this particular police officer, can be brought to book so that this doesn't happen again. So I hope all efforts are being made to make sure a watertight case is being made against this particular individual.
Undoubtedly. We're all working on it, and we'll ensure that this person actually gets convicted, because as I said, the department is very, very serious about it, and we are all ourselves very shocked by this incident. So undoubtedly, we will leave no stone unturned to ensure that this person gets convicted and justice is given to the victim.
All right, and how soon can we expect progress on this case? If you can give us some timelines on what what is going to be done going forward.
We are actually we have started the investigation. The process is going on, and we'll be present the charge sheet as soon as possible. And as you rightly mentioned, it will be a watertight charge sheet, so that no loopholes are seen.
And before we let you go, how soon can we expect a charge sheet to be filed? When will this case roughly go to court? If you can give us some kind of rough timelines, how many days or weeks from now on can we see developments?
We have given ourselves, we'll be not taking more than a month. But that is like the extended, we cannot extend beyond one month. So within 1 month, we want to get done with all the investigation and present a good charge sheet.
All right, Isha Pant, the SP of Tumkuru, thank you so much for taking time out to be this year on The Big Story of Magic Bricks. Now, Brinda Adige, we just heard out Isha Pant, the SP of Superintendent Police of Tumkuru. I hope that she follows through on her promise because that's crucial, at least now, that we cannot let this particular menace to carry forward.
I'm sure she is going to keep her word, and it is good enough because she has assured us and the confidence that the SP is following it up and is very, very clear that she is not taking more than 30 days to get this whole thing charge sheet and have a watertight case. And I'm sure this would be a precedent across the country.
All right, Brinda Adige, we will let it go at that. Brinda Adige, thank you as always for taking time out to be with us here on The Big Story on Magic Bricks. Now, here's hoping that justice is done in this particular custodial rape and molestation case to make sure that no policeman in this country, in any state, dares do this again. And with that, we wrap things up on this particular edition of The Big Story on Magic Bricks. Now, thank you so much for watching. This is Krishna Kumar signing off.
You can watch live TV on our website, mbnow.in. Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/magicbricksnow. And don't forget to click the like button. You can also follow us on Twitter at magicbricksnow. To stay updated with all our programming, hit the subscribe button on our YouTube channel by logging on to youtube.com/magicbricksnow.